Back of three now, Ernie Els. This is for a birdie, too. One of the holes that was changed during the renovation. Look at the pace on that putt. How about it? Just ripped it in the hole. And our first look from behind the tee. This is Rod Pampling, one of the co-leaders. On the tee, beautiful par three here that has been lengthened for this championship. And that is a really good shot right there, right behind the hole.
Come on.
Oh. A little bit to his left. Kind of like that. When you get the pace right, it can go in on all sides of the hole. Plus two for the championship end around. Played it up pretty close to this green. See if he can get some action on it, which he does.
This is one of those holes that you would expect to make birdie on, but not from there.
This could be really good. Better than good.
Oh, wow.
Is that any good?
Are you kidding me?
Can't drop it out of your pocket any better.
Jeez. That was a nasty spot. Lie was, you know, unpredictable.
Standing on some buried rock.
Well, that was Houdini there at the fourth.
Player whose name pops up and off these leaderboards on a fairly regular basis at these big senior championships, and that will move him up back to even par. Nice score there.
The left side trying to cut back.
Should be good. It was soft enough.
Yeah, 163. That hole on the front portion of the green, you got to carry it all the way back. There's a false front that goes up about halfway there. And it's out to the right.
And this green falls off. Ooh, he gets a great kick there. This green falls off on the front.
This is Clark for birdie now at 18.
Yeah, he thinks it's going to go a little bit left at the end. At least that's what they indicated earlier.
This is the... Oh, he gets it to drop on the right side.
Here's Tripp Keeney over at 17 now. Drove the ball in the fairway, which is job number one here. Dangerous second shot if you're coming out of the rough, but not the fairway.
Oh, come on. Go in.
And this is Rod Pampling at the long par 3 7th.
Rod's always been a good long iron player, good hybrid player, and that's what the 7th it calls for. He is up just a little bit today. This is a really long par 4. Beautiful. Just five birdies. Could this be the 6th?
Yeah. Illinois golf coach Mike Small. He was a college teammate of Steve Stricker, who's been just a force out here. Stricker will tee off later, but his good buddy Mike Small already throwing in some birdies from long range like he did at the third there. He had the lead by himself just a little while ago.
Here's Mike Small, second shot, 505 yards at the par 5. This man is a ball striker. He's played a lot of good golf in his career. It's amazing when he goes out with his players on his University of Illinois team. They're not giving him any shots right about now, I can tell you that.
What a shot.
What a shot. Yeah. He's back in the lead. Mike Small at minus 3.
This is the third.
And here's a man who knows how to win a U.S. Open, Ernie Els. Just a little bit of a baby fade into this whole location, and that is the shot shape. What a beauty.
Els now. And that is really, really good work. Ernie Els at even par to get into red numbers. This would put him 2 back of the lead.
Scoring average right now, Jimmy, is just under 77, which is plus 6.
Wow.
So It's a total mindset change when you come out here to play a U.S. Open or U.S. Senior Open. Is normally everybody's running to make a bunch of birdies. Here, pars, you gain incremental shots on the field.
Does it surprise you, though, that the scoring average is that high?
No. Two-time winner of the U.S. Senior Open Championship, 2013 and 2017. How about?
Oh, man.
Looking for a third championship.
That was going at the left side of the green.
So a meta for that power game reaches the heart of the green in two. And Jake, you were alluding to very impressed.
Huge fan. I really am. I mean, it's a straightaway test of the game. It's as you mentioned, a throwback sort of golf course. I mean, it's tall, rough corridors. You have to drive the ball in the fairway.
I know. Well, I went past that age quite a while ago.
Me too.
Blew right on by. A good shot. Whoa. There for Lehman. No surprise. A little right to left draw. Could've been there for Tom.
Second shot now at the par four. Padraig Harrington. Peter, looks like he laid back of that bunker. Took your advice.
Yep.
And that's the result.
Well, that's what happens. And it's, as I said earlier, it's a different mindset.
Padraig Harrington, let's see if that cautious approach can pay off here for birdie. Yep, nicely done.
This is a 7-iron.
That's the number.
A little breeze off the left. This is just a little bit right of the hole.
Oh, wow. Best we've seen today. Yep, good shot. Now he can attack that front left pin.
It's really quite cool. This is O'Meara in position. Just a little wedge in here at 11.
And a wonderful shot from 104.
Happy birthday, right? Finally.
Being the tough guy.
Adelson De Silva, who we saw at the Senior PGA Championship. Finished tied for 20th. This is this tricky shot for Alcor from behind the green at 18.
Wow, that's really good. Go in.
How is that happening?
Go in.
Ho-hum par for Alcor. And he's going to get in with a 75.
Going to have to land just about 10 feet short, and that first bounce is pretty big. That's got to get down.
Yeah, both he and Lang are long. Quickly back over to 18 just a moment ago. And that looks a lot like
Shinnecock
19 years ago.